Amanda with Straightsmile Solutions, straightsmilesolutions.com, and today we're going to talk about the age-old question, do you need retainers after phase one treatment? And every orthodontist you ask is going to give you a different opinion. My answer is always, well, it depends. Let's talk about what the patient started with and what we did. So I'm not going to go ahead and circle back because I have like 13 hours of phase one interceptive education, and this isn't going to make any sense unless you've already learned everything, because it's gonna make zero sense. So I recommend that you go ahead and listen to that. At the very moment, you can find that education kind of all dispersed within my YouTube channel. I stuck it on my, I stuck the playlist on my website at Straight Smile Solutions. You can look there, you can go to my YouTube channel, which is Straight Smile Solutions, scroll down, find the playlist. But if you want something a little more concise, where it's all organized and like neatly in a flow, I've created it, yay, and it's launching today. So, it is available on my website, the Phase 1 Interceptive course. It's a 13-hour course without CE, with help on two cases, and it's $999. You have 90 days to finish it. Or in about a month or two, it'll be available with CE, without the help on the two cases. A little bit cheaper, you know, even though it's with CE. Of course, you have to take a 65-question quiz in order to get your CE, and it's not a joke. I'm writing the quiz right now. I actually have to make a real quiz. It's not gonna be crazy easy, so you'll have to know the stuff to pass the quiz and actually watch the course. But you won't get help on the two cases, but it's gonna be launched by the company CE. Zoom is the one that I picked to host my platform and give the CE. It's currently getting certified. It should be available by I'd say December 2022, if not January 2023. Check in with CE Zoom about their phase one interceptive course. They're the ones that are doing it. I've turned it over to them. They're building it for me. And they're gonna get it certified for CE. But that would be on-demand CE, so make sure that your state allows on-demand CE. I know my state only allows 20% of your 50 CE units to be on-demand CE. But I mean, that would pretty much fill my need for the two-year period. So excited to help you out and to teach you this, but yes, basically depends on what you did. Certain types of movements are pretty stable. So if the phase one was only fixing a bite, say transverse correction, as long as you held that transverse for the normal period of time of 3 to 6 months, you should be fine. But you could put in a TPA or something, which would hold the transverse. Let's see what else. If you did vertical correction, like a deep bite correction, again, you gotta hold it for 4 to 6 months. As long as you did that, should be fine. You usually get a tiny bit of relapse, 10-20%, but it should be fine. But you could bake that into some type of retainer for sure. Lower jaw growth is generally pretty stable. You might get 10-20% relapse. I tend to like to try to overcorrect, almost take it to edge to edge. But again, shouldn't relapse, should be fine. But if you aligned some teeth, now it depends. How did you align teeth? Did you expand the arches and then align teeth? Or did you just pull out baby canines and align teeth, right? So for the most part, if you're aligning teeth, they're gonna relapse because those fibers, they have memory, right? The PDLs, so they're gonna relapse. So if you want the teeth to stay straight for phase two, then you'd need some type of retention. I go over all the different retention options for phase one in our phase one course. Take a look. I'm not gonna go over it because it'll take me an hour. But lots of different options out there. If you just, let's say you expanded the top arch, did a 2x4, or did phase one aligners to try to consolidate the space from 7 to 10 or upper 2 to 2 so that you had less likelihood of impacted canines. If the canines are coming down vertically and they're already past the height of contour of the adjacent teeth, nah, you don't need a retention. You know, will everything be completely straight when you enter phase two? No, probably not. You're gonna have a tiny bit of relapse. That's normal. So, I mean, it really depends on what you did and what the parents' expectations are. If they're gonna get upset, if 8 and 9 move a little bit, well then, okay, do a retainer. If they recognize that most patients that have phase one need phase two, most, not all, and the need is an air quote, because need, I talk about medical need. Like, we need phase two because we have an impinging overbite, or we need phase two because we have an 8mm overjet, or we need phase two because we have an impacted canine. Yeah, that patient needs phase two. Do we need phase two if there's a 1mm diastema distal to upper right two? No, you don't need that. That's cosmetic, right? So need, okay? So if the parents are already 100% committed to phase two and they don't wanna deal with retainers, totally fine. You know, as long as they realize there's going to be a tiny bit of relapse on the aesthetic portion, I'm cool with that. Probably have them decline the retention and sign a little paper just to make sure. But if they're kind of, you know, parents that would get upset about that, then I mean, I'd give the options and let them know that we'd be, hey, we're glad to do a bondy retainer. We're glad to do a thorough. We're glad to do some type of lower lingual arch for the lower, you know, a lot of things that we can do. So yeah, it's a personalized approach. So you got to refer back to the original records and what mechanics you did. All right. Thanks so much.